Sinon, on continue nos entrevues spéciales album avec une artiste d'origine éthiopienne qui est née à Montréal. C'est une artiste hip-hop. C'est l'une des découvertes du corner que nous, on a fait en 2018. On l'a connue avec la track Rara. Et elle était mise en vedette sur Spotify dans un segment New Music Friday. Vice la big up, Apple la big up, King Size Magazine la big up. Et ce soir, on la reçoit sous le corner. Elle vient nous présenter son premier album, Higher Self.
That's a
Faites
movie.
Du bruit pour Naya Ali. Higher Self. Donc, Naya, how you doing?
Oh, I'm fabulous.
So, what's so going on since the last time we saw you?
Oh, that's crazy. What was it, like last year, last April?
Yeah, last April.
Man, a lot of things. A complete change. A complete 180.
Mm-hmm.
I think back then I only had two records out. So we launched the EP. I got signed. I quit my job. It's manifesting reality. So
living your best life.
Yeah. You're living your
creating
best
my best life.
Life.
No, exactly.
Yeah, creating.
So how did you get in touch with Koyup Music Records?
Oh, man. Like, everything is just, you know, I never actually go after stuff. I just let the universe just fall through. It was super random. My management had a meeting with them for another artist. And then he just slid my name in there, you know, and then he got really... Raphael got really curious, mm-hmm. and then he checked out my stuff, and then he just got super freaking excited.
C'est so, vraiment nice, man, yeah. de savoir que une compagnie comme Koyup ont leurs options ouvertes, puis ils sont ouverts d'esprit pour aller chercher un talent comme Naya. C'est sûr que dès la première écoute, tu dis, aïe, c'est qui a signé elle? Es-tu signé elle? On peut-tu faire de quoi?
Non, je suis contente qu'il l'ait fait.
Non, vraiment nice. Non, vraiment, vraiment nice. And now, how Universal get into that business?
Well, Koyup Records is under Universal. Okay. So they're the distributor. So okay. It's distributed by Universal Music Canada.
So, do you are we going to hear a Dr. Dre feature, a exhibit, Eminem? I don't know.
I mean, hey, possibilities are endless, you know. But I'm just super excited.
You called your album Higher Self. Is it the best Naya that we're hearing right now?
The best Naya is the Naya right now. There's a lot of layers to me. I just put out one layer. One at a time, just a little bit, a tidbit. I'm working on the album right now, and that's, you know, I'm showing a little more of myself and what I can do.
No doubt. So, can we talk about a little bit about the album? Six tracks.
Oh, the EP, you mean?
The EP, yeah. Sorry, six track. Let's start with Ali.
Yes.
Is it
last name Ali? Motherfucker, it's me. So, I bring the sauce to the kitchen, motherfucker, I got heat.
So, talk about that track.
What could I say? It's called Ali. It's the first introduction. It's just, you know, it's me coming out to the world and standing my ground and speaking things into existence. Like, I mentioned a lot that I'm a legend in that song. It is
just
what
like
it is.
Just like Muhammad.
Last name Ali. You know, it's funny, like, my last name is Ali, but growing up, I never really liked my name.
Why?
Because they call me Alibaba. I was like, fuck. And the 40 Thieves. I was like, really? The black kid, 40 Thieves, Alibaba. But you know what? As I grew up, I found out, I didn't know, but Ali means elevated one. So, like I said, things just fall into place, and it's just meant to be.
Nice.
How do you stay so humble?
My mom.
Okay.
My foundation. I was just raised like that. Like, no one is above anybody else. Mm-hmm. You stay humble and you stay grounded. You know your worth. You know that you're a god, but you should still stay humble.
Are you from a big family?
Not too big. No, it's my mom, my brother.
No doubt, yeah. And Ra Ra was a track that we all know. And why you choose to put Ra Ra in that project?
I mean, Ra Ra is the catalyst, is what started everything. My first record that I put out, that record I actually recorded at one shot. First time I was working with that producer. It was just like first for everything in that record, so it meant a lot. And when I put that out, that's when I got my management team. That's when everything started rolling out. So it was important for me to put it in there.
Out the Dirt, same thing. It was.
Yeah, but I mean, it also the EP kind of tells a story as well. You know, Rara is really deafening the noise, the external influences, and Out the Dirt is really like, all right, cool. Now it's time to get to work. Nice. To rise.
And Rails. Yes. I feel it's like
you fuck with Rails.
Yeah.
I feel like you would fuck with Rails.
It's like you showing your skills on a sick beat.
Yeah.
And you rapping your ass off on that track.
That's what it is. I mean, you know, you got to show what you got. I'm a complete artist. I mean, I'm a rapper, yes, but like I'm a complete artist. But when it's time to go bar for bar, when it's time to fucking rap, you want to mess with Ali? Don't let this cute face fool you.
I like that. And then you slow it down with Peace of Mind.
Yes.
You're singing on that nice beat.
Mm.
Why you chose to sing on that track?
I didn't choose to sing on that track. It just so happened. I was feeling emotional. It tells a story. You know, it's called Peace of Mind. Peace of Mind, not Peace of Mind. It's a play on words. You know, when you give yourself to someone in a relationship or whatever, you lose that part of yourself and you can't get it back. So, you know, sometimes we want to get that peace that we gave, but once you give it, it's gone. You know, you have to give it freely.
Since you're a rapper, like, weren't you scared of people's reaction hearing you singing?
No, not at all. No, I don't give a fuck.
I think singing,
I just do me.
Singing and rapping is a Canadian thing.
You know?
People will say, oh, she's from Canada. Yeah, she has to sing, you know.
But there are certain records that you, like, at least for me as an artist, I have to sing them, you know, because the emotion
just feels like it.
Yeah, it just feels like it. The spirit takes you to sing it. For me, at least, I don't know.
No doubt. Okay, next year. Let's talk about the album.
For sure.
Do you have a name?
I do have a name.
A window frame for.
I'm aiming for like spring, summer.
Okay.
Spring, summer. Yeah.
So what's the name of the album?
I can't say it right now. I'm crafty. But I knew it before I even got signed.
Okay. Yeah. So could we expect some features? What kind of features could we expect?
I mean, maybe. Yeah. Features are definitely on the table. Mm-hmm. But more than that, it's like when you're a new artist, it's like, why get all these features when we don't even know who the fuck you are? Mm-hmm. I'd rather, you know, stand my ground.
Focus on
come in, you know, like a bomb that I don't need features, you know? Mm-hmm. Some people, they think that they need features. You don't need features.
You don't.
Exactly.
No doubt.
I don't think I do.
So, how can we get the EP? How can we?
Oh, man. Apple Music, Spotify, Tidal, all streaming platforms, Bandcamp.
They love you at Apple, huh?
They, you know. Yeah. we got a good relationship.
Nice. So, anything else you want to add up to your EP coming out?
Anything else to the EP? Yeah. Well, Peace of Mind is a single. Video should drop pretty soon. Soonish.
Who's filming? Who's producing the video, you know?
It's a big team.
A big crew?
Yeah.
So what kind of concept can we expect for this track?
I mean, it's the more emotional track, so...
Yeah.
Yeah, a little bit more of a concept, a little bit more of...
Acting?
I mean, hey... I did take drama.
Yeah.
Thank you, Naya.
Hey, thank you for having me.
If we want to get in touch with you, how can we do it?
Sure. Best way is Instagram, Naya Ali the Original. I'm on Facebook too, Naya Ali Official.
No doubt. Et j'envoie aussi un shout out à Pat Laflamme.
Yeah.
You know.
Shout out to Pat. You know, he's sick right now. You know, he has a little headache, a little cold.